Man, thank you guys for coming today. I know, moms, you had a choice this morning, and it was to sleep in and tell everybody to stay out of the room. But man, I hope God blesses you today for coming to church with your family. Such a cool deal. Hey, we're in the middle of, we're coming to the last two parts of this series called Recovery Road. And you see on the picture how you really have two ways to go, you know? Sometimes we're raised in a way to not go certain directions, right? And so you have to make a decision. And so we started on Easter Sunday. We started on Easter Sunday. Many of you were here. We talked about how, man, real recovery starts with the resurrection, right? And Paul said, if there was no resurrection, why do we sing songs? Why do we talk about Jesus? Because he says, if there was no resurrection, then everything else we do really doesn't matter. Everything else we do doesn't matter. The prayers, the breakfast, the coming, the getting dressed, the nice suits and ties and the flowers and all of that really doesn't matter without the resurrection. So we said, man, so if we believe there was a resurrection, then it moves us in a really awesome direction. It moves us towards redemption. It moves us towards restoration. It moves us in the direction of real life change when we believe that there was a resurrection. So it started on Easter, and today, man, I thought very appropriate that today we talk a little bit about reducing the stress in our lives. How about that? Amen? Uh-huh. Yeah, really? That's all you got? Yeah. I mean, reducing stress, right? Come on. Yeah, you're like, let's do this. Let's reduce the stress in our life. So, pastor, I heard a story this week from a pastor who told a story about actually his associate pastor was driving behind this big truck. It was like from a Petco company or whatever. And he was driving behind this truck, and at every stop, the driver would get out of the car or get out of the truck, jump out, and he had a 2x4, and he would hit the side of the truck. Boom! Boom! And then he'd jump back in the car and keep going, or in the truck and keep going. And he did this, like, not once, not twice, like 3-4 times. And so he'd jump out, he'd hit the side of the deal. And so finally, the associate pastor, he's like, I got to figure this out. Like, this is going to be a story. You know, we're always looking for stuff that can preach, by the way. So if you got stuff, tell me. But so he's like, I've got to figure this out. And so he goes and he finds the guy. And he's like, what are you doing? Like, why are you doing this? And he goes, can't you see this is a one-ton truck that I'm in? I am driving. And he's like, I mean, you know how you get when you're stressed, right? So he's like, I am driving a one-ton truck, and they have 2 tons of canaries in the back of this. So I have to keep half of the canaries flying every time that I stop, or this truck will not move. We won't go any further. And so, you know, the pastor's like, wow, very genius, very smart, because we'll do anything we can, won't we? We'll go through crazy lengths, anything we can to not be overwhelmed, right? Everything we can to figure out how can we reduce or relieve ourselves from stress in our lives. We'll do anything we can. And man, I think of this story, and I think of us, right? And so when we think of stress, right, here's what we know what stress is. Many of us maybe have your own definition. Here's something that I saw this week, okay? It's an adverse reaction. An adverse reaction people have to excessive pressures. An adverse reaction that people have. When you think of reaction, do you like just like think of a rash? You do too, don't you? This is free. It's not even in my notes. I'm like, I just thought about that. A reaction is that's just like a rash. Like bumps start coming up. And then you ever see people post pictures of their rash on Facebook? Of all the places, keep it off Instagram. I don't want to see your rash. All right? I don't want to see the reaction you're having to something. But it's like, that's what, when we're talking about stress, that's what it looks like. It's an adverse reaction. We're having this rash, emotionally, sometimes physically, to excessive pressures or other types of demands that are placed upon us. Excessive pressures or other types of demands placed upon us. This is a stress. And it says it arises, it comes up, it wells up when they worry they cannot cope with it. You cannot cope. Overwhelm. What are some of the things? Okay, what are some of the things we'll go to? Like some of the links that we'll go to whenever we're stressed. I'm literally like in my bathroom today, and I'm just like thinking about this. And I'm thinking, you know, I'm going to bring some props. I'm just going to bring some props literally in one room in my house. And my wife is a clinic manager of two clinics and gets calls all the time, so she's stressed. So she figures out different ways like that her stress will be relieved. One of them, just while in the shower today, was right in front of me, and it says stress relief on it, and it's some type of eucalyptus spearmint soothing body scrub of some sort. Does this really work? Like when you know, when you're doing the thing, dude, immediately do you think, I'm stress-free? All of these kids screaming and these people calling me, this is amazing. I have no more stress. No. All right. Or what about this? A aromatherapy spa in a candle. Just in a candle. Like you can just light it and instantly music is playing and you're in a spa. Okay, so maybe you just light it and it's a Yankee candle, so I guess it's good. All right. Stress relief when you light the candle, cinnamon and frankincense. Yeah, we'll just add a Jesus word in it and we'll let you know. If we just add a Jesus word in there, the people will see it, especially the Christians. The Christians will read it and we'll buy it and we'll be stress-free. No. Okay. All right. And then this one I found, because I was just going crazy. I'm like, I got to look in the cabinets and everything and see if there's other stuff. This one is one of those bath bomb things, right? Like you get in the water, and if you drop it in, it starts to fizz and go out, and automatically, somehow, life is better, right? Life is so much better. We all, listen, that's just in one room of my house, stress relief and all this stuff, and I'm sure there's other things that you have, right? But what do? Like, we find all different things we can try to relieve our stress. A couple of our staff members just went on vacation. Oh, vacation. If we can just get to the beach, if we can drive 14 hours in a minivan, if we'll make it to the water and we'll look out and there'll be other people who are now just relieved of all their stresses in that one moment, right? And then I'm like, welcome back, Mark. Get up on the stage. We got to do this Disney thing. Come on, man. Come on. You know, it was like temporary, but we figure out other different things that we do. Exercise one. Yeah, I have a friend here that always wants me to go exercise. How come I get more stressed when I'm thinking about going to exercise? Like the text comes in to me, 4 a.m., and I'm like, no, I'm stressed. You just made my stress go higher, you know, so exercise, but, you know, they'll tell you, you know, of course, all the statistics, exercise, you'll feel better, you'll be, you know, those things happen, right? How about this? Avoiding conflict, right? Yeah, just, you know, you've got issues, but I'll just stay away from those people, and if I stay away from those people and I avoid conflict, then my stress will be better. Here's a little secret about that, you know. Until we deal with that, it always comes back, doesn't it? It comes back in the form of another person that's ugly or whatever. All right. And then how about time with friends? Time with friends, you know, stress relief. Oh, man, if I just get some time with my boys, man, if we can go out and we can shoot something, right? I'm going to go out and shoot something. If I can get a hog and shoot a hog, I'll feel better about myself. Or if I can go with my ladies and we can hang out and watch Tim McGraw or whatever, you know, I'll feel stress relief or whatever. Okay, and then there's other ones that we deal with. Some of us are like, oh, these are funny. But then there's other ones we get into, man, other ones that are serious, you know, like, man, alcohol, tobacco. Man, if I can figure out something in a can, if I can figure out something in a pack, something in a bottle that will just relieve the stress. But man, aren't these all temporary? Aren't these all temporary? And some of them are very dangerous. Some of them are very dangerous. Hobbies, man, things that just take over us. But here's the deal. And here's what we know. And this is great from the Bible, okay? From just, again, just people who walked around with Christ and just wrote down what was happening. Wrote down things that he said. And one of the guys' names was Matthew. And Matthew wrote down this event where Jesus is just talking about stress. Okay, some of us are like, did he ever say stress? Yeah, listen to this. This is when he talks about when life gets overwhelming, what you do. And so today I thought, man, especially a day for moms. Moms, you guys got such a heavy load on you, you know, and husbands, we don't have enough compassion. We just don't. I mean, we're just we are. It's just terrible. We need to be better. It's like we need to have more compassion to what moms and our wives deal with. And it can overload them. But, you know, we're all overloaded at times. We are all overloaded at times. So what if I told you this, that Jesus gives you everything you need to know about stress management? That he gives you everything you need to know. Where we go and we find it in all other ways, right? We find it in every other way, and I listed several of them. But in Matthew 11, there's just three verses in Matthew 11 where Jesus is just saying, I am the rest that you need. Like, I am the rest for your stress. And so there's two words today I want you to take with you, okay? Two words, but there's going to be a bigger phrase, but I think it's just two words that you can get. Say, Jesus rest. Jesus rest. Jesus rest. Okay, now, Jesus rest will reduce the stress. That's what we're going to go with. That's the thing today. Jesus rest will reduce your stress. So now when you're like, man, you're stressed, here's the thing. We're going to get to it in just a minute. You need Jesus rest. That's the kind of rest. I need Jesus rest, man. Your friend, you know, calls you up and you're freaking out on the phone. She needs to say, you need Jesus rest. You know, not just you need Jesus, but you know, yeah, but like you need Jesus rest. You maybe need to tell a friend, you need Jesus rest, okay? So today we're going to look at Matthew 11, where he talks about stress management, okay? Matthew 11, 28, this is where we're going to start. You can follow up on the screen. If you're online, you can follow along on the app, wherever you are. Check this out. So Jesus... Again, we think that people weren't like us back then. Like they didn't have their levels of being overwhelmed. We're in a new age. We're just more overwhelmed. People were overwhelmed and stressed all the time. That's what they do. When they dealt with finances, when they dealt with providing for their families, when they dealt with relationships, when they dealt with trying to fulfill their goals and dreams in their life, and when they dealt with all of these things, there was always stress, right? There was always this going on. And so Jesus is speaking to this now. He's speaking to this. And so obviously there's this conversation going on about this. And so then Jesus says, come to me. Come to me. All of you who are weary and that carry heavy burdens. Can I get an amen? Is that any of us? All right. You're like, these people are kind of like us. All right, cool. And he says, and I will give you rest. He says, take my yoke upon you. Let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle at heart, and you will find rest for your souls. He says, for my yoke is easy to bear, and the burden I give you is light. All right, that's the reading of God's word this morning. And here's what he starts with. You know what he starts with? He says, the first thing you do when you want to reduce the stress in your life, when you're on the road to recovery, right? And you're feeling it, you're redeemed, you're feeling restored, you're going, and you have stress in your life that's still overwhelming you. He says, the first thing you do is you come to Christ. You come to Christ. And many of us, we think that's too simple. But think about this. People came to Christ for all different types of things, didn't they? Like, we can open up the stories and we can see how people came to Christ for all different types of things. In the Bible, many people came to Christ for problems that they had. Many people came to Christ for questions. They just had questions. Many people came to Christ because they had illnesses. Like, they needed healing. Remember the lady, let me just touch your shirt and I can be healed, right? Maybe they came to Christ because somebody that they loved had died and they needed just help with coping. It was so heavy upon them. And then there were people that came because for their reasons, because they wanted to trap Jesus too. How about that? That people came because they wanted to prove this whole shenanigan wrong. People came for that. People came to Christ for all different types of reasons. But here's what we know. However you come to Christ, he never criticized anybody for how they came. Like, he never criticized them for how they came to him. He just said, come to me. Come to me. So here's what we'll do. We will try to get it all together before we come to Christ, won't we? Like, we'll try to figure out, we'll do it all the other ways, and then we'll show up to church. Then we'll try, then I'll come. Or I'll answer your call when I get it all together. Or I'll come to the community group when we got our marriage back together. Or I'll come to your men's, you know, breakfast. Or I'll come to the mother, whatever the thing is. Or I'll come to you, God, in prayer when I get things together. And we don't have that in Scripture where that happens. It's people just came to him. Came to him. Some of us are like, you know, why do you do what you do? Breakfast and Disney games and tacos and fishing and all these different things is because everybody doesn't come to Christ the same way. Everybody doesn't come to Christ the same way. I went to youth group the first time because somebody invited me because girls were there. Yes, first time. Sorry, confession. I'm like, I like girls or whatever. And so I went for the first time, and guess what? That night, I came to Christ to know him. You think the people who came to Christ when he fed the 5,000 all were coming for some great spiritual sermon? No, guess what? What does it say? The people were, somebody say it, hungry. People were hungry, physically hungry. Man, and they came to Christ. And so it's evident, like by Scripture, that, man, it's not, we always think we got to get it together first before we come to Christ. If you are stressed, if you are overloaded, overwhelmed, he says the first thing you do is come to me. Come to me. And physical rest is not enough, right? Physical rest isn't enough. Like, you need, here's what we need, right? We need spiritual recharging. We need emotional recharging. We need mental recharging. We need relief from anxiety. We need relief from our tensions. We need relief from our guilt and from our shame, from just the past that we cannot get over, from bitterness. And Jesus says, man, when you are stressed out, the first thing you do is come to me. And bring it with you. Bring it with you. What are the things we turn to for stress relief? Okay, I mean, we talked a little bit about them, but some of the things like are just, we just want to go numb, don't we? So we'll turn on Netflix and binge watch shows. Like we'll just be like, I don't want to think about anything else, or I'll watch something else, and we'll get those things right. Or what are some other things? Food, right? Food. I mean, we'll do that too. Like, let me just eat, and I'll just need to eat. You know, some of us think that physical intimacy, I'm just going to say it, sex, okay, will do that. And we figure out that it will not. It will not be the stress relief. Jesus says that none of these things are going to take care of the soul. And remember what I said earlier about how we'll try to relieve the stress through these things, but it's the soul that needs to be relieved. It's the soul. Isaiah 40 says this. It says, God energizes those who get tired, and he gives fresh strength to dropouts. He says, those who wait upon God get fresh strength. You hear that word fresh? Someone say fresh. You like fresh stuff, don't you? Like, anybody ever gone to like the where you're getting the fruit and the vegetables and you see people like, you know, grabbing things and they're like touching them and they're like knocking on them or whatever? You know why they're doing this? Because they want the freshest version of what that is. They want the best. I mean, really, only like dads or whatever, we go in there and grab the first thing. And it's just, I always go home and my wife's like, did you even like look at these or whatever? And I'm like, oh man, I know, to get the fresh thing or whatever. In my first house, I had this just small house, like 900 square feet house. And I had some tomatoes, and I had been known to have some things that had kind of been a little old in the house, okay? You know, my brother one time ate cream cheese that expired 2 years before. Yeah, it was awesome. It was hilarious. It was so cool. He was like, this is a little sour, this cream cheese. And he's like, when is this from? I was like, I don't know, man. He's like, looked at it, cool, man. And so, but here's the thing. I did have a tomato. It was a good tomato. I had a tomato there in my house, and I was going to have a sandwich. I just wanted a good sandwich. And the tomato looked fresh on the outside. It looked perfectly fine on the outside. And if this has not happened to you, then this is an amazing story and I'm the only one, but maybe it did happen to you. But I got this tomato and I cut open the tomato and it opens up and this white, pussy stuff starts coming out. Have you ever been sprayed in the face with like red pepper or mace or something? If you had, you got problems. The smell that came from it was into the house immediately. Anybody ever opened up a rotten something like that? Thank you, one person, awesome. It was not a trick, okay. But it did, and I opened it up. But you know what, for me, like I'm sitting there and I still think about that tomato and I'm thinking it seemed fresh on the outside. And what we do is that we will do everything we can to seem fresh on the outside. And on the inside, we are rotten. Rotten. And the first time somebody comes and opens us up, that pus starts to go blah, out and we reek of what's on the inside. And man, Isaiah the prophet, he says, man, God is the one who makes you fresh from the inside. From the inside. And so why is Christ saying, come to me? Because it all ties together. He says, come to me. I will give you freshness. And when you are tired, your wings will spread out wide. They will soar like eagles. They will run. You will not get tired. They will walk. You will not lag behind. He says, I'll give you that freshness. Okay, so all right. So we're going to go on to the next step. Okay, next step. How do we get this? How do we get real Jesus rest? All right, Jesus rest. How do we reduce that stress? Okay, second one is this. This is going to be a tough one for you, okay? Give up control. Give up control. When Jesus is talking to us, Matthew 11, 29, This is good, because some of you think you're going to think this is something else, but it's not. Matthew 11, 29, he says, take my yoke upon you. Now, how many of you maybe thought like me, how is that a deal? How is that a deal where I'm going to be stressed, you're going to reduce my stress, but yet you're telling me to take more, right? Have many of you felt that before? How about many of you who maybe have come to church? And you get here, and you're experiencing it, and you're feeling it, and then someone asks you to do something. What is this all about? I don't want to come and do. I'm tired, and you're going to put more on me. Well, see, this is how Christ works, right? Many of you think a yolk is not the yellow part of the egg that does with the cholesterol. Okay, sorry. All right, that's not what he's talking about. So, all you people who have been farmers before, the yolk is this wooden thing, has two things, and the animals go put their heads in it, right? And when that happens, horses have it, cattle, you know, the cows will do it, and they are going to plow or they're going to till the land. When you put two in there, when you just had one, right? When you just had one in there, it was going crazy. But you put two in there, and the focus began to happen. And the plowing began to happen correctly. I got any farmers here? Farmers? Yeah? Anybody ever seen one of these? I got no, you city people. All right, there we go. Yeah, we've seen this, right? And so now you hear this, and you're thinking, oh, wait, so when we have our own stuff, and we're stuck in it, like we got our head in the thing that we're dealing with, and we're going in circles, and we're tilling up nothing. There's no harvest. It feels like, what is happening right now? And then Christ is like, let me take that off. Let me put mine on your neck, on your neck, right? And you're like, this does not sound fun. All right, let me put this on your neck, and let me get in there with you. Man, he says, because what does he say? He says, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Man, just think about that practically speaking. Your issue, whatever it is that you have, the things that you struggle with, the things, whatever, and you are that thing is around your neck, and then the creator of the universe, the one in John 1 that says, in the beginning there was nothing without him, he was the one, gets in the yoke with you. And now your problem, wow, how's that feel? Yeah, just move your neck around a little bit, right? Just let's do that exercise. It feels lighter when you know that. Psalm 55:22, I love this, because it gives us two things about being yoked with Christ. Listen to this, these two things right here. The first thing is this, is we, before we read the scripture, that a yoke is a symbol of partnership together. When Christ calls you and he says, put my yoke upon you, he says, let's partner up against the thing. How about that? Let's partner up against the thing that you have. So it's the first symbol is partnership. Psalm 55:22 says, pile your troubles on God's shoulders and he'll carry your load and help you out. I love that. Pile them up on God's shoulders and he'll carry your load and he'll help you out. The second symbol is this, that a yoke is a symbol of submission or surrender. How many of you just want to say, I cannot do it by myself? I mean, it's almost like we need to say it out loud to really believe it. I cannot do it by myself. And man, I love this. I love this. Where, man, you are in a partnership with the one who says, just say it. Just say it. I cannot do it by myself. The Bible says in Romans 3:28, it says, our lives get in step with God by letting him set the pace. Our lives get in step with God by letting him set the pace. And here's what we know, okay? You're going to be yoked to something in life. You ever heard someone say, you're going to worship something? I mean, it may not be God, but you're going to worship something. Like we'll go through life worshiping something. Then I love this. You're going to be yoked to something. And you get to pick what it is. And Christ is inviting you. Take my yoke upon you. He says, for it is easy. For it is easy. Finally, this. So to find real Jesus rest, remember Jesus rest. Someone say Jesus rest. That's right. Jesus rest is what we're doing. If you're a first timer, we're not a cult. All right, we just do that. All right. So to find real Jesus rest is to reduce the stress is this. Come to Christ, give up control, and finally, learn to trust. Learn to trust. Learn to trust. Proverbs 20 says, since the Lord is directing our steps, why try to understand everything that happens along the way? Isn't that it? Isn't that it that how about this? How about this? When you've gotten the explanation for the thing that has sent you crazy, when you've gotten the explanation, did the explanation help you? Did the explanation, No. Many of you are like, oh, yes, it did. It did. Let your husband do something that sends you crazy, and he gives you some explanation and reason why. Does it change the fact that you were still going crazy? It does not change. We want explanations. We're like, well, I just need to understand. If I understand everything, if God, you'll just help me understand everything. Remember how that started? In the garden? It was this need that you can understand everything. And when you understand everything, you'll be fine. And we haven't stopped, have we? We haven't stopped. And you know, maybe you don't want to get into the spiritual battle, warfare, and everything else, but I'm just going to tell you, that's where we are. It's what we know. Ephesians 6:12 from last week, we are fighting against powers and authorities that are evil, that wants you to keep saying, I just want to understand. I need the explanation. And then when it comes to like faith and church and God and stress, we just keep saying to God, I need to understand. I need an explanation. And the author of Hebrews tells us that without faith, it's impossible to please God. And what is faith, right? Isn't faith trust in God? See, I think we have to learn to trust, man. I think for us, and I know I want to suggest this just today as we're coming towards the end here. I think we've tried a lot of things to reduce our stress, but have you really tried just trusting in God? Just learning to trust. And for that to happen, you have to unlearn a lot of other things, don't you? You have to unlearn that you are the man. Right? You got to learn that. Not just like you're a man. No. You've got to unlearn I'm the man. See what I'm saying? You've got to unlearn that mentality. You've got to unlearn the mentality that you have to do everything for yourself. So for us to learn some of these things, we have to unlearn the others. And man, there's this invitation by Christ. And this is good because it's going to take us right towards the end here. There's this invitation by the one who's the lion, right? I mean, he's fierce. This is what we know about him. I mean, right, we sing the song, roars like a lion. So for me, like I'm sitting here thinking about this, where he's inviting us to come to him with your stresses, your struggles, your all the stuff you have. And he's saying, let me put my yoke upon you. So the one who gets in is the lion, has that spirit. And I'm thinking, man. See, because some of us think that it's the Jesus that's very meek and calm. I like that Jesus too. But when it comes to my problems and my issues and my struggles, I want the lion to get in. I want the one who's going to go tear up things. And he's going to order the steps. But we have to trust that will happen. We have to. And he's inviting us to that. And so I think the invitation today, when we're talking about Jesus' rest, is real rest for you. Not this temporary rest, but real rest, Jesus' rest, Jesus' rest that reduces your stress. And you can rub this stuff all over you. You can light it up. You can throw this bomb, pew, throw the bomb into the bathtub. But then close your eyes and pray. And say, man, it smells good in here. But all this is good, but Jesus, you're the rest I need. And the kids are banging on the door, put the headphones in, Hillsong United. Jesus, you're the rest that I need. It'll change your whole spirit. And he's the, man, I'm telling you, he is a roaring lion. He is a roaring lion. So today, I thought we're going to close out with a video that, okay, it's a tiger, but I was like, I can make the connection. Because moms, you deal with this a lot, stress management. I know my mom did. My mom was a single mom for a long time. I knew she would go off and cry in places that I didn't know. She'd drop me off kick me off to my grandma's house and then peel out. I was like, why does she peel out every time that she leaves? Like, this is Dukes of Hazzard or something. Like, mom, where are you going? Like, gravel going everywhere. But we know that moms need, you know, stress management. But moms, you have a tiger inside you if you believe on the name of the Lord. So I thought I'd show you this really sweet video for you moms. Check it out.
The day starts before the crack of dawn. Feed the baby, then get breakfast on. No quiet time for me. This day is crazy. Wake the kids an hour till school begins. Check the sheets, he's wet the bed again. Extra load of laundry shouldn't mean a thing to me. Go find your shoes, go brush your hair. The dog threw up and it's everywhere. Her diaper's full, it's time to go. Stop fighting or lose control. I may get down, but I'll get up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all, I see it now. I got the eye of a tiger, a fighter. Dancing through the fire, cause I am a mother. And you're gonna hear me roar louder. Louder than a lion, cause I am a mother. And you're gonna hear me roar. You're gonna hear me roar. Homework's done, it's time to get them fed. Bathe them all and get them into bed. I went from zero to my own hero. The kids can't sleep, her past year's gone. Who knew the day could be this long?
Yes. So a gift for all you mothers today. We have vacuums and strollers behind the building. You can grab a bat on your way out and go right around and just get with it. Man, that's the tiger you have within you. Amen? Amen. You have that, man. So listen, here's what I want to do. All you moms, stand up. Stand up. Moms-to-be, moms. Maybe you're going to have a baby soon, whatever. Stand up, stand up. Yep. Give them a big hand, moms. Yeah. I wanted to hear you guys roar, but I don't know if you wanted to do that. Man, I'm going to pray for you moms as you're standing. Heavenly Father, thank you so much that for these moms especially, God, who get overwhelmed, have been overwhelmed in life, God, that you call us and invite us in to a relationship with you through your son Jesus, who says, come to me. Come to me first. Don't try all these other things. Come to me first. And so, God, I just thank you that that invitation is for these moms in their lives as they're overwhelmed at times. And I pray today would be a time where they felt like their stress was relieved, not just because of a breakfast or a sermon or whatever, God, but because of your son that they know they can come to, that they can light that candle, God, drop the balm in, and that they can pray to you, God. I pray for all those, God, who are here today, who also are overwhelmed and need stress relief, God, that you are the one who will reduce that in our lives. Thank you, God, so much for that opportunity we have to do that. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Amen.